UTS-15 is unlike the Kel-Tec. The Kel-Tec's a kick-ass gun. Problem with it is if you need to reload it, you have to flip it over. So basically, you've got the gun upside down and you're manipulating rounds. The only way that's gonna work is if you've got somebody covering you. Nice thing about this, it's got two loading ports. Okay, it's real simple. That's one, there's one on the other side. Okay, just like any shotgun we've ever worked our entire lives. You can mix and match, and you should be able to see the rounds all the way out. You know what you got, you know what you're dealing with. Okay, flip, you're picking up each tube. The nice thing is, unlike the KSG, with the selector in the center, you're feeding left, right, or right, left, right, left. Okay? Close these up. You're now set and ready to go. First one loaded in the set position. Okay? You reach down, push the button at the back. First round comes in. Straight up. Okay? Real simple. So, should you have a malfunction or a jam, it's real simple. Okay? This entire set comes up, you're able to access just about everything from inside here. Okay? This is a fairly simple setup. You need to swap out. Okay? It's real simple. Just drop one in. All right. Well, I'm taking it apart, quick cleaning, make sure the sucker's empty. Come back up to the front, just like every shotgun on the planet, guys. Take this front piece off. Okay. Normally, this would be the mag tube. All right. You're gonna pry this up one more time. Wish I had it up, should have left it alone. Okay. This entire setup comes off. Okay. Inside here, real simple. There's your bolt. Okay. This is your tubes, your barrel, rail, everything. Everything you need. Truthfully, this is as far as you need to take it down. Putting it back together, this is usually where I screw everything up. If, you know, I'm just like you guys, I do not read the instructions. All right. So this goes back in. This goes back on top, and if I screw this up, I'll definitely cut it out because there's no need in showing you my idiocy. Alright, so that being said, push the button in the ass end, which exposes the locking setup, and screw it down. From there, everything's golden. Trigger is a nice, maybe 4 pounds. No mush, no bullshit. Okay? Nice, simple setup. Okay? And since it's TDS, I guarantee you within 20 minutes it's gonna have a red dot on top of it. You can put Magpul flip ups on it. Comes with sling mounts already in. These are, you know, the nice ones. This, honestly, nice damn gun. Nice. Yeah, as promised. Flinch at the end. I loved it. This buttstock is really a pain in my ass. So, let's load it up again, see what it does. Alright, so, one in the pipe. Let's see what happens this time. This should be the full 15. eighth of inches. Yep. I don't think I closed it. Alright. Let's run some more. Unload show clear. Alright. I've been fiddle farting around with it. I know what it is I'm doing. This grip, it's an AR-15 grip. It is perhaps the worst designed grip I've ever seen in my life. You know what? Since this is the one we're keeping at the shop, a Hogue or a, probably a Hogue is going on here. This thing is painful. The other thing is I'm trying to count and I'm not paying attention. I'm also gripping up high and the sling swivel's coming back and whacking me in the thumb. I go boo-boo. Okay, a couple minutes ago I showed you how to take the top up and load around. Real simple, with this thing open. Just drop one in. I don't know why I gotta make things more complicated than they are, but that's the beauty of me. Honestly, I'm about as thrilled as I can be out of this thing. It's cooler than shit. Other models will have the light set up so that as you're up on it, you're able to click the light and give it hell. This, number one, this is cooler than shit. We had every bit as many operator errors with this one as we did with the Kel-Tec. Okay, truthfully, I would much rather have this. This is far easier to see the rounds. It's far easier to manipulate. The only thing, in my opinion, it's missing is the ability to put a stick or the Magpul angle foregrip on it. It does have a setup here, but until I actually get a sling on it or take the sling swivel off, it's not going to fly. All right? Anyway, yeah, as far as the buttstock being a pain in my ass, yeah, it's a pain in my ass, but, you know, everybody will tell you, I'm not a shotgun shooter. I will blast the living hell out of shotgun. Actually, you know what? Yeah, let's blast. So, from the angle, you obviously know I'm hip firing. What I wanted to show you one last time, you ought to be able to see the rounds in this thing. If you can't, I'll cut them out. But trust me, it's far easier to see than in the Kel-Tec. The window is pretty goddamn huge. Okay, so I have six. It says seven at the very end, which is kind of silly because that's what a follower is. I don't think you can take the follower out. Could be wrong. It's not in the book. All right, so one goes in here. Listen. Hear it? That's a pretty sound. The other one, if I can get it correct, I don't want to turn around and freak everybody out on the line. The other one goes in here. Okay. That's what I did the last time. I didn't latch it all the way. The thing's got a very strong detent spring on it. It's real similar to the dust cover on an AR, except for this one, trust me, is strong as hell. All right. And the very last one. Goes in the pipe here, thusly, and let's see if we can control this, keeping the hand far away from the little swing swivel, what is that? All right, here we go. Flinch, because if you're doing it this way, you're actually looking down. You're looking down the numbers. It's real easy to see each round going shoop, 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 shoop. Okay, so another question we've got is the selector. All right, it's real simple. You go this way, you have blocked off this side. You go this way, you have blocked off this side. Don't ask me right and left, doesn't matter. The side it's pointing is the side you blocked off. So, you got slugs in here, you got buckshot here. Or you got, double up buck, incendiary, explosive, tear gas, whatever rounds here, okay? It's an easy deal, okay? You go in the middle, which is where I've been shooting the whole time, it alternates. It alternates, and it picks up on the left first, then the right. You can change that, but that's coming in here and pushing a little doohickey thing. Don't ask me what it's called, because I don't know. All right? You can change which side it starts on. Bottom line is this is an incredibly cool 15-shot shotgun. I like it. This one is staying at the shop. I am changing to a Hogue grip. Okay? And as soon as the light setups come in, man, I'm gonna be a bad boy. It's got laser, it's got flashlight. Theoretically, it's got both, but one way or the other, it's got a flashlight, it's got laser, it's cool. I got a door breaching setup. And if you get close enough when I run out of rounds, as I'm doing the Jesse Abbott over the top, under the bottom, through the side, I can poke you with this. This is cool. UTS-15. Yes, we have them in stock. Thanks for joining us for another wonderful effort called What the Hell's on the TDS Bench. Sorry you had to see my fat ass holding the gun, but you weren't here. Shoot straight.